good morning to you.
Good morning.
Lock at night.
God, you're gonna make it. I'll keep.
Morning. It's 4:30 in the morning. We have lots of things to do today. We have lots of stores to go visit. We have lots of donations to pick up. We have a lot of hungry Arizonans to feed. So let's go make a difference.
How are you doing that store? Does anybody have anything for us today? Anybody have anything to share? You don't get a voice. Anybody else have anything? Okay, so today we have Preston here. He's gonna do bands and exercise. So let's go stretch.
Start swinging, right leg, simple leg swings, back and forth.
For 15 minutes, we stretch to warm up the body, loosen up the body, to save the body from any back injuries or any kind of injuries. And so it's a new program that we've brought out, and the guys love it. Every morning, every driver is required to do a quick inspection. That's for to make sure that, you know, the tires are safe, the lights are all working, to make sure that we're on, following the DOT regulations. So that's a requirement every morning.
Make sure your belts are tight. Make sure everything's proper. Antifreeze is good. Then, I also come in and look, but then I also get the ask the meat manager if he has anything. Hey, Boston, buddy.
What's
up, man?
How are you?
Excuse me? Do you have anything?
Do you have a couple things in the back?
Okay, cool. Do you have anything for St. Mary's today?
No, we don't.
Okay, have a very nice day.
Do you have anything today?
You gotta walk to every department and just ask and just take a little time out to wait, you know, and get something, you know. And just take that little few minutes.
Day. This is my deli, like the frozen chickens and stuff. So I always put deli frozen. So, you know, when I put it, it'll get put in the freezer because I picked it up frozen. So I want to kind of make sure it gets put back frozen. So I'll write deli frozen on it, deli frozen, because it's like a deli item. So when it gets back, that's how they determine the weight. You want to keep your cooler and bakery separate too.
Okay, how do you do that?
The cooler and the bakery need to be separated.
Okay.
together, but keep it all on one pallet.
That's what you got in your hand.
It's the donation form of what they gave you.
Right.
The poundage, and you always put down the poundage, and then you gotta sign it.
Okay, and then what do you do with that?
You turn this in at the end of the day, so Chris and you go through it. See what stores are donating and what who are not.
Okay.
At the end of the day, Tom has to call in to myself or whoever the dispatcher may be, he calls in to see if there's any more stops, any kind of pickups that needs to get picked up or rerouted to help us out. Their manifest will dictate where they go at the end of the day. It'll either go to one of our partner agencies or it'll come to either one of our facilities, which is the West Side or St. Mary's Food Bank facility. And so today, this particular load's coming to the Delaware facility, which is at St. Mary's Food Bank. As a St. Mary's store route driver, there are other responsibilities that on any given day you could be called on to do, such as we have food drives, we have homebound, special events, picking up citrus, delivering Boys and Girls Club, and even driving our DOC bus. When the driver starts off, he starts off with pallets with nothing on them. And so as the day goes on, he builds his pallets. So as you can see, he has a double pallet here. So he picked up this bin at a store, then he put an empty pallet on top of it, and he continued on to build his pallets. And he put a pallet on top and made this from the different stores. He builds pallets because of space. When our driver gets back to our warehouse, while they're unloading, they have different categories that they build all day long. So they start unloading, they unload by freezer category, there's cooler categories, there's bread, there's dry goods, and there's canned food drives.
When you do your first stop, like me, I have Sam's Club, and my stuff's already binned for my Sam's Clubs, so I'll put them on. But then, like, if I get to my next Sam's Club, I might have two or three bins, so I might pull that short bin off and put that high bin in the back. Because when you're driving, and if you have to stop suddenly, you don't want everything to tip over. You want to keep your pallets as high as you can in the nose of your trailer. And then you get to your second stop, it's all about maneuvering. You know, you're gonna have to maneuver stuff, you're gonna have to move stuff around, you know, just to make sure that your loads don't tip. You don't want to come back with stuff spilled all in your truck. Your markers and guns are supplied to you, and you should tag all your boxes, all your product you bring back, like deli. You need to write deli on the all the boxes. And then your guns, always make sure that your gun's properly loaded. and it has enough ink in it so you could read the DN numbers when we come back.
How do you prepare your truck for the end of the day?
The next day we prepare our trucks by putting at least 10 pallets on our truck, 4 bins, your pallet jack, and 10 food dry boxes, and that's it.
Today we're at Casa Primavera, and it is an assisted living site that we come and drop off, distribute homebound for the seniors. We do over 1,100 clients per month, and so this is one of the sites that we come and deliver homebound to. We will see the driver drive up, and he'll start unloading his pallets, and he'll go inside in their main lobby. And all the clients know that they're supposed to come down, and they have to show their ID. Our driver is responsible to make sure that the paperwork is 100% correct, because it's a government program. And so he's to verify that that is the client before he can distribute any type of box. They get a box, and then a box of cheese, and some dry milk. And also today we have bread for the seniors. So that's really a bonus.
Bye, thank you.
I don't know if you noticed, but when he was unloading the truck, he brought down a pallet, and they're very, very heavy. And so that's how he works all day long. He starts with a full load, and he has to use his lift gate all day long. And he also, those boxes are pretty heavy, and he delivers to every site. So.
So what's the toughest thing about your day?
The toughest thing about my day? Waking up at 4:00 in the morning. That's the toughest thing.
So what would you say to anybody who would like to apply for this job? What's the most important thing that they know?
Oh, it's a great job. The people here are very friendly. Everyone's like a family. Everyone's really good to each other. And you get to meet, you have the sincerity of what you're doing is you're helping someone else. When you're going out and you go into stores and you try your best to get what you can, you're bringing something back to help someone else that's hungry and needs a meal. So it's great. I love working here.
I got some stickers on my face.